It's very important to recognize that a woman with low functional ovarian reserve shouldn't be treated the way you would treat somebody routinely. These women, these ovaries are very sensitive to the kinds of treatment approaches. At CHR, we take a special approach to women with this condition, and it kind of involves two general sorts of steps. One is we pre-treat women with a variety of medications and supplements that are designed to build the potential of the ovary to produce healthy eggs. In recent years, we've been using DHEA and CoQ10 to try to improve that status. But when you get to the ovulation induction itself, there's some important differences. Traditionally, in an ovulation induction cycle, there are two types of medications that are being used. The medication you use to drive the follicular development forward, and that's the gonadotropins, what you would classically call fertility drugs. And then there are medications that you use to slow that process down and maintain control. In younger women, there's an emphasis on trying to maintain that control because you don't want somebody just to ovulate spontaneously before you can get the eggs out. However, in older women, those medications are used for control, what we call the GnRH agonists, like Lupron, or the antagonist, like Cetrotide or Ganirelix, can be too heavy-handed. And our approach is to use these methods of control, but very judiciously, and only the least amount that we have to maintain control. When we use Lupron, we use a very highly diluted form of Lupron, which we call microdose Lupron. And that still gives us a little bit of control, but it doesn't overly suppress. If we're going to use the antagonist, we use just a touch, just near the very end, just to try to maintain control so they don't ovulate. That allows the fertility drugs to be able to have their full effect and to drive the ovarian follicular development process forward without putting too much back pressure on it that might slow it down. We see too many people coming from other centers where they've been fully suppressed either with an agonist or an antagonist and have no response at all. We think that's unfortunate because they spend so much effort on their cycle. We think it's best if people get some sort of response.